Hello everyone, in this video we'll see hands-on lab for AWS Solution Architect course. So in this first lab we'll explore and interact with AWS Management Console and AWS command line interface. The Amazon Web Services or AWS environment is an integrated collection of hardware and software services that are designed to provide a quick and inexpensive use of resources. So the AWS API sits atop the AWS environment, and here the API represents a way to communicate with all the resources. So there are different ways to interact with the AWS resources, but here all the interaction uses the AWS API. So the AWS Management Console provide a simple web interface for the AWS, and the AWS command line interface, which is the AWS CLI, is the unified tool to manage your AWS services through the command line. Whether you access AWS through the AWS Management Console or using the command line tools, you are using the tools that make calls to the AWS API. So here this lab follows the Architecting Fundamentals module, which will focuses on the core requirement of creating the workloads in the AWS. And this lab reinforces modules discussions on the what, where, and how of building the AWS workloads. So students first will explore the features of the AWS Management Console, and then will use the Amazon Simple Storage Service, which is Amazon S3 API, to deploy and test connectivity to an Amazon S3 bucket using two different methods. One will be AWS Management Console, and the second would be AWS CLI. So in this lab, objectives will be, first we'll explore and interact with the AWS Management Consoles, and then we'll create resources using the AWS Management Console, and we can explore and interact with the AWS CLI command line interface, and then we'll create a resource using the AWS CLI. So first we'll explore and configure the AWS Management Console. So as you can see here, I have logged into the AWS Management Console. So here in the from this console, we can choose the AWS region. So here on the navigation bar, you can choose the region, as you can see here. And you can select the region appropriately based on your location or in which region you want to work, and you can change the region here. And here you can choose the account name. So here I can see AWS lab user, and from here you can just click on the settings. So to change the default region, under this localization and default region, you can click on edit, and you can click on this default region. And for example, I'm going to change it to US East 1 and save settings. And here you can see I have already in a different region, US West 2, And once you changed, you need to go to the new region so that it will be changed to US East 1 here. So for this lab, I'll be using the last region which I used. US West 2. So to go back to the main page, you can click on this AWS logo and it will take you to the home page. And next here we can see the unified search in the AWS Management Console. So for example, in this search you can type cloud, and here we can see all the available matching search option. And from here we can just click on the services, and it will take you to that services. Let's say if I want to go to the EC2 instance, then you can just type EC2 and select the services. And to go back to the main page, you can click on this AWS logo and then it will take you to the main page. And to add and remove the favorites, you can do the things from here. So if you can click on this services and go to all services, you can find all the services. And here we can see the star button. If you can make this, it will be added to the favorites. You can also click on recently visited, and from here, for example, if you wanted to make EC2 in the favorites, you can just enable this star, and then you will see it under the favorites. And similarly, if you wanted to remove this, you can just remove it like this. And to create and use the widget from the main page, as you can see here, the plus add widget. So you can click on that, and here you can select the widget to add it to your console home. For example, here I'm just selecting the favorites, and then you can click on add, and you can see added the widget favorites. Find it at the bottom of your console home. Click and drag to reorder your widget, or you can change a widget size using the widget menu. So you can also rearrange this widget. You can just click on here and take it to the place where you would like to place it. And you can also change the size. And if you want to remove the widget, you can just click on this three ellipse icon and just remove widget. Okay, here also you can see the add widget option. Okay, so next we'll see how to create the S3 bucket using this AWS Management Console. So in the search option, you can type S3 and you can click on this S3 scalable storage in the cloud. Okay, so here you can see that there is no there is one already which says insufficient. Okay, so to create a new bucket, you can click on create bucket, and you need to provide the bucket name. And before that, you need to make sure the bucket name must be globally unique and must not contain spaces or uppercase letter. So you can just go to this link and see the rules. that you know, you can apply for this bucket name. So I'm going to give the bucket name. And AWS region US West 2. Okay, so by default it will block all public access, and versioning I have not enabled, default encryption disabled, and I can click on create. Okay, so we have successfully created the bucket name called ACG lab bucket 01. Okay, so we have created the bucket, and let's upload some object into the Amazon S3 bucket using the console. So you can just click on the bucket that we have just created. And here you can see the option to upload. You can just click on that, and here you can, you know, add files, add folders. So I'm going to add some files. So I'm just adding the image file. Okay, and click on upload. Okay, so the upload succeeded. And just close it. So now we can see that the image file uploaded into the S3 bucket. Okay, so next we'll see how to create the S3 bucket and upload an object using the AWS CLI. So let's go back to the main page, and here we can search for EC2. Okay, so click on instances, and here we have the command host instances running. So you can just click on connect, and here under session manager, under the connect to instance, you can just click on connect. Okay, so now we are in the CLI interface. So here we will use the high level S3 commands with the AWS CLI. So to list the existing bucket, we can use this AWS S3 LS. And here you can see that the one which we created using the management console, this is the one. And now we are going to run AWS S3 MB S3 lab CLI bucket, and we'll put some number here. Okay, so we have created one bucket. Okay, lab bucket, we just created the one. And next we'll copy some object into this bucket. So have some file already in the home directory, so I'm going to copy that AWS S3 under home SSM user happyface.jpg. Copy this into the lab CLI bucket. Okay, so now let's list AWS, S3, LS. Okay, so we can see that the file that we just copied from the home directory to this bucket, we can see it here. Okay, so that's it in this video. So we have learned to interact with the AWS Management Console, and we have created resources using the AWS Management Console, and we have also interacted with the AWS CLI, and we did also create the resource here in the AWS CLI. Okay, so that's it in this video, and thank you for watching.